What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you 10 lighting tips and tricks in V-Ray 3.6 for SketchUp. Let's get started. The first one is to use shortcuts. For example, let's create a rectangle light. Now look at the bottom left of the screen. It says select first point, hold shift to control direction. If you are not familiar with rectangle lights, by default, it only shines on the front face of the plane. So there are often times when you have to flip the light after it's created to get it to point in the right direction. With this shortcut, you can just click on a point, now hold down shift and click the second point to create it. Now you will see a blue arrow which indicates the direction that the light is pointing to. Just move the mouse to the other side to flip the light, then click again to finish. As you can see, it's a lot faster when I use that shortcut. Similarly, there are also shortcuts for dome lights. By default, it has a basic HDRI loaded when you create it. But if you hold shift and click, then it will have no texture. And you can hold control and click to load a custom texture as you are placing the light. Another light that has shortcuts is the spotlight. Normally, you would click wherever you want to create the spotlight, then move and rotate the light, and finally make adjustment in the settings. But when you use a shortcut, you can hold shift and click on a starting point. Now you can move the mouse to adjust the direction of the spotlight, then you have the option to adjust the cone angle, and finally you can choose the penumbra angle as well. With the shortcut, you can set the direction and preview the effect of the spotlight very easily. Number 2, create lights inside components. If you have multiple instances of the same lights fixture in your scene, don't add the lights one by one like this, but rather go into the lights fixture component and add the lights in there. That way, when you add it to one instance, it will be added to all of the other instances as well. And you can use the lights editor to adjust all three lights at the same time. Number 3, mesh light tips. There are times when you need the light to be in an odd shape. For example, in this scene, I have a mirror that I want to have LED strip lights all around the perimeter. To create the light, I can go to the components and select the geometry that represents the light, then make it into a group, and use this button here to turn it into a mesh light. Now let's render it again to see how it looks. Pretty cool, huh? Number 4, emissive material tips. There are two ways to use emissive material to simulate a lit light bulb. One is to apply an emissive material on the bulb itself. And the other way is to apply the emissive material to the wires inside the bulb. This way, you can see the glass material of the bulb and the inside wires. This makes the render more detailed and realistic. There are also other ways to use emissive material, such as creating fire like I showed in this previous video. Number 5, use lens flare. To make the lights look even better, you can add some lens flare after you render it. To do that, I'm going to click here to open up the lens effect settings, then click here to turn on the glare effect. Now I can make the adjustment here. Looks pretty good so far. If you want to take this to the next level, you can go to this location on your computer. Then open up Filter Generator, which is a tool to compose filters for the lens effects. Here you can experiment with the settings to create a lens flare that you like. Once you are happy with what you have, click here and export an HDR file, and choose a size here. Then go back to SketchUp and change the glare type from camera perimeters to from image. Now you can click this button here and load the lens flare file that we just saved. There we go. You can always switch back and forth between the two types here. Pretty cool, huh? Once that's done, I can save all of the render elements with this button here. You can also watch this video here to see how I use the lens flare image as well as other render elements in Photoshop. Number 6, isolate your lights. When you're adding multiple lights to the model, sometimes the lights all blend together and it's hard to see the effects of each one. So a good way to study your lights is by isolating them. With the interactive render running, you can turn all of the lights off except one. Adjust the power of that light until you see fit. Then repeat the process for the rest. After that, you can turn all of them back on to see how it looks. This is a back and forth process that you need to experiment with. But sometimes you don't know which light to turn on or off because they have generic names like this. That's why this next tip is just as important. Number 7. Organize your lights. The first part of this is naming your lights. To make it easier to find your lights, use the lights editor to rename them. I usually add the location of the light into the name of each one. First, I will right-click the light and click Select in Viewport. I can now see where it is in my model. In this case, it's in the shower. So I can double-click the name and add the word shower in place of the word V-Ray. Then I can repeat this process for the other lights as well. This makes it a lot easier to locate your lights in the editor so you can work more efficiently. The second way to organize your lights is to put them on layers. If a model has a daytime and a nighttime view, then I would add the appropriate time of day into the name of each light like so. Next, I would create separate layers for daytime and nighttime lights. Then I can assign each of these lights to their appropriate layer. And finally, I would set each layer to be turned on or off depending on their respective view. Now, if I switch to the daytime view, you can see that the night lights have turned off and only the day lights are on now. This way, I can easily switch back and forth between the nighttime and daytime render by just clicking these tabs here. This works perfectly even in interactive render. Pretty cool, huh? Number 8. Use correction controls. When you render, there are times when you get burnt out areas like this. If I click on the forest color clamping button, it will show me the areas that are too bright. To fix this, I can open up the correction controls, then click here to show the exposure settings, turn it on, and turn down highlight burn until I can't see the clamp colors anymore. Now we can turn the clamping off, and there we go, it's not so burnt anymore. This makes the image lose some contrast, so you can increase it here. There we go. Number 9. Use light textures. Using texture maps is a great way to enhance your lights. For example, you can use a light texture to create a TV screen effect. First, I'm going to use the rectangle light as the screen. And I will go to the light editor and add a bitmap texture for the light. I will choose this picture of Thanos here. Sometimes the light texture doesn't have the right orientation, so you can fix it by flipping it or rotating it like so. Now I can increase the intensity here. There we go. I can also increase the directionality a bit to make the light beams more narrow and focus it in one direction. You can use this method here to create realistic light fixture like this as well. This texture was downloaded on hdrlabs.com, which is a good resource for HDRIs. This takes me to number 10, which is lighting resources. Here are a couple of resources to download free HDRI that you can use for lighting your scene. You can use these for small lighting textures like this, or for dome lights like this. I will leave the links in the description box below. One of the really good sites that I use is HDRI Haven. This has a ton of HDRI that you can download, and it's all for free. If you want to create your own HDRI instead, then check out this course on Skillshare.com, who is also the sponsor of today's video. Skillshare is a learning community that currently has over 22,000 classes in design, photography, and more. The premium membership will get you unlimited access for less than $10 per month. But as a part of this sponsorship, Skillshare has set up a 2-month trial for the first 500 people who sign up, so you can watch all of their courses completely for free. If that's something you're interested in, then go to this link here. I will also leave the link to the course I just mentioned earlier, which is creating realistic lighting using your own HDRIs. This course shows you how to create a simple HDRI using only your phone and Photoshop. The author uses Cinema 4D to render, but you can easily use the HDRI for V-Ray. Another course I liked is called Create Photorealistic Interior Renders with 3ds Max and V-Ray. This one shows you a step-by-step tutorial from modeling your scene to lighting and editing in post-production with Photoshop. And that is all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video and comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.